Grace and peace to you from God our Creator and our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ.
Amen.
So the question was posed, how long will you keep us in suspense? If you are the Messiah, tell us plainly. Now for inquiring minds, this is an honest question. Who really are you, Jesus? You've done all of these amazing things. You've done healings, you've taught about the good news of God, you've fed 5,000 people, in fact, you even walked on water. Who are you? Now the inquiry within our Gospel of John for today. Jesus' identity was not done out of excitement. It was not done out of curiosity. And it was not asked, boy, if I only knew who he was, I now will be formed spiritually. This question about Jesus' identity was meant to entrap, condemn, so that they could arrest and even put Jesus to death. And to do so, they wanted proof that he was speaking words that were blasphemous. For the Messiah, in their eyes, fit into certain criteria, and this Jesus, well, he did not. So in short, the Jewish leadership wanted to label Jesus to excuse their behavior. Now, in this case, in the section right after this in John chapter 10, they were ready to pick up stones to stone Jesus to death. If he was the Messiah, we therefore can get rid of him in a very painful manner. But they needed him to label himself. They needed a label for Jesus. And I'd like for you to notice, he doesn't give them an answer that they are looking for in our gospel. He doesn't give them an answer at all. Before we get there, let's talk about labels. It is a common and unfortunate practice that we all do. We enjoy stereotyping this person and the other, therefore we assume that this person or the other is a certain way. Well, he's German. Therefore, he likes Lederhosen and Oktoberfest. She is Italian. She uses her hands to talk. And a good cannoli. He's Irish. He drinks too much and is stubborn. That person is Caucasian or African American or whatever it may be. And then we assume that person fits into that pigeonhole. We are so much more than the labels that other people put on ourselves, or the labels we put on ourselves. So as an exercise, I wrote down all the labels for me I could in 2 minutes. So this is your pastor, and here it goes. I am a son. I am a son-in-law, a husband. I am a father, a brother, an uncle, a friend, a pastor, a singer, specifically a crooner. I'm a Dallas Cowboy fan. I'm a Milwaukee Bucks fan. I'm a River Cats fan, a San Francisco Giants fan. I am a Star Wars geek, a Star Trek fan, a goofball turkey. I'm a superhero fan, especially when it comes to Batman. I'm a bird watcher, a prayer warrior, a cat lover. I'm a lover of all things avocado, asparagus, and beets. I'm a lover of good music. I'm a Boy Scout, a supporter of chaplaincy to veterans. I'm a good listener. I'm a scripture lover. I love the works, or I am a lover of Martin Luther's works, in particular the Augsburg Confessions and the Small Called Articles. I am laughter. I am German-American with a smidge of Scotch-Irish. I am all of these things. Some of you probably said, well, now that explains it. And others, you may have been surprised. But did you know I'm also these things as well? I am an epileptic. I am a sufferer of PTSD. I am an extrovert that is often lonely. I am weak. I am lonely. I am broken. Yet none of these labels mean a thing in the sight or excuse me, yet none of these labels mean a thing in sight of the label that was given to me at the waters of my baptism, where I was named, claimed, and proclaimed as a child of God. As I've listed all of these labels, maybe you are one of them as well. Now, with this list of labels, my purpose was not for you to say, hey, let's look at Pastor and let's have either some joy or awe moments with him. My point, though, with these labels suggests that they do not tell the whole story about a person. Too often, labels belittle. They crush, they break relationship, divide us, cause suffering and pain and way too much anger. How long will you keep us in suspense? If you are the Messiah, tell us plainly. And Jesus answered, I told you, and you do not believe. And in some obscure way, I wish he would have listed the 200 plus names that are given for Jesus found in scriptures. Well, you could say that I am the Messiah, but I'm also known as the bread of life, the resurrection and life, the Son of David, the truth, the Alpha, the Omega, the author of eternal salvation, the beloved Son, the door of the sheep, the Holy One of God, the Good Shepherd. Now, which one of these work for you? However, he responds in a different way to their question. He speaks these words. The works that I do in my Father's name testify to me. But you do not believe because you do not belong to my sheep. My sheep hear my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life and they will never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. What my Father has given me is greater than all else. And no one can snatch it out of the Father's hand. The Father and I are one. Instead of labels, in which the Jewish leadership were so hoping for, Jesus rather speaks in terms of his actions with those whom he loves. Jesus is the giver of life, the bestower of love. Two things that are hard to pin down, but so powerful nonetheless. So much more than a label. Rather, Jesus' words are about a holy relationship where you are loved as God's unique, carefully created, sometimes chipped, maybe even broken, cracked, awesome creation. That's what you are. Let me tell you a story. It's about Jim, who was a former member of this church. Now, looking at Jim, you would have thought he was a tough cookie. And he was. He was as hard as a brick. An Air Force colonel with so many awards to back up his toughness. I met him later in his life, but still tough even in his powered wheelchair that he went around his neighborhood with. And I'll admit to you that I was rather nervous when I first met with him. Now, I've heard many stories from various church members about this guy. Watch out for Jim. He'll bite off your head if you're not careful. And as I walked up the stairs to his front porch, I'll admit to you, I trembled. Why? He was staring me down from his front porch. Good morning, sir. I am Pastor Scott Gimmer. I am your new pastor from Christ the King Lutheran Church. And he reached out for my hand and he said, hello. And as we shook hands together, he then pulled me toward him in his power chair into this huge bear hug. And he said, Pastor, you're all right with me. Let's talk about the love of Jesus. Not much I could do when you have no balance and he's in your holding you tight. The only thing you can respond to is, okay. And so we did. For a couple of years, I would come to visit his home and we talked of Jesus and Jesus' love over cookies and lemonade. And it was actually kind of funny. Every time that he would we'd run out of lemonade, he had this caretaker that would go, "We're out of lemonade! Chop, chop!" And whoever the caregiver was would come with this, you know, huge pitcher full of pink lemonade and et cetera. But for years we would do this back and forth, talking about God's love with lots of laughter. Initially, he was labeled a tough guy, but little did we know that he had a gentle heart and a passionate one for his Lord and Savior. Until one day, when I got a call about 3 a.m, and it was Jim's caregiver, and he was calling, he said over the phone, "He's calling for you." Jim was being called home. And as I approached his bed and we did our regular handshake that we always did, "Pastor, I'm going to see my drill sergeant in the sky. Thank you, Pastor, for loving me to this point." Of course. And then his weakness, he saluted me. And as I saluted back, "Thank you, Colonel." And Jim passed away about an hour later. A label that we gave to this person was one of rock solid hardness, when the reality is we should have given him a label of a foundation that was firm in Jesus Christ. Too often we label ourselves and others, and we do it to ourselves, and we do it to others, when here in our gospel, Jesus makes it quite clear. Hear his voice. Follow him, and now live. Now and eternally.